Aloha, I'm Jermyna van Dyke, an MD from Out of the Doldrums. Today, we'll be taking a look at a small but mighty compound called urolithin A. We're going to talk about what this molecule is, how it is created, hint it involves the microbiome, and why it's so beneficial for overall health. Urolithin A is a natural gut microbiome-derived food metabolite. It all starts when we eat a food that is high in elagitannins. These elagitannins get converted to elagic acid in the small intestine. Elagitannins and elagic acid are polyphenols that are present in highest concentration in walnuts, pomegranates, and blueberries. This elagic acid travels through our GI tract and makes its way to the small and large intestine, where microbes in our gut digest the elagic acid, and then they excrete the compound urolithin A. Not just any microbe can metabolize elagic acid, though. There's only a certain specialized few that can get the job done. Some of these microbes are Gordinobacter urolithin faciens, Gordinobacter pamiliae, Elagibacter isourolithin faciens, Bifidobacterium pseudocatenolatum, and one of my favorite microbes, Akkermansia mucinophila. If you missed my video on Akkermansia mucinophila, check it out. There's a link in the description below. It's a good one. Here's where things get really interesting, though. There are some factors that seem to decrease our ability to produce urolithin A from elagic acid. These factors are aging, body weight, and overall health status. The older we get, you see, the less able we are to produce urolithin A. Similarly, the more overweight and more unhealthy we are, the less likely we're able to produce the compound. We don't really know for sure why that is, but researchers speculate it's because our microbiomes are different. We lose the specific bacteria that we need to do the job. Essentially, being a urolithin A producer requires an appropriate gut microbiome, and this microbiome varies with age, health status, and dietary intake of certain foods. This process is highly variable. One study demonstrated that only about 40% of the human elderly population are urolithin A producers. The good news, though, is that studies show that many of us who are not urolithin A producers can potentially become producers just by eating a whole bunch of foods with elagitannins and elagic acid. Bring on the pomegranates. Our microbiome adjusts depending on the specific foods that we eat. This is all another really great reason to keep working on that microbiome diversity, to keep those specific bacteria that we need to metabolize elagic acid into urolithin A. So, assuming we are successful in this endeavor, we, with the help of our gut bacteria, have now created this compound, urolithin A. It acts locally in the intestines to protect gut barrier function and to provide a direct anti-inflammatory effect. It's also absorbed in the intestines and then into the circulation. From here, it travels throughout the body and it has various actions in different locations. Let's review the benefits of urolithin A. The most consistent effect of urolithin A across all species is the improvement of mitochondrial health. This effect is seen in cells, worms like C. elegans, mice, and humans. It does this by recycling and clearing out dysfunctional mitochondria. This process is called mitophagy. When mitophagy occurs, the old damaged mitochondria get recycled, and this leads to the generation of new mitochondria and improved cellular quality. As we get older, our ability to clear out the dysfunctional mitochondria is impaired, so being able to restore this process is a very promising strategy to counteract age-related decline due to mitochondrial aging. Along those lines, scientists have found that urolithin A increases the lifespan and health span as well as performance of a worm called C. elegans. Another important benefit of urolithin A is its anti-inflammatory properties. Urolithin A has been shown to have a strong anti-inflammatory effect. This is very relevant because aging and most age-related diseases are associated with chronic low-grade inflammation. It's called inflammaging. Urolithin A has been shown to down-regulate inflammatory molecules like TNF-alpha, interleukins 1, 6, and 12. By doing this, a very well-known pro-inflammatory pathway called NF-kappa-B is suppressed. These anti-inflammatory benefits extend across all the systems of the body. So, at the end of the day, where exactly can the health benefits of urolithin A be seen? Let's review system by system. First, the muscles. There's some evidence showing that urolithin A can increase muscle strength and endurance, as well as decrease age-related muscle dysfunction. Second, the heart and cardiovascular system. Urolithin A was studied in a mouse model of ischemic reperfusion injury, basically a myocardial infarction or MI, also known as a heart attack. There were two groups. One was pretreated with urolithin A, and the other was a control group. The animals that were pretreated with urolithin A had a reduced infarct size, and their cardiac function was much better preserved compared to the control animals who did not have urolithin A. This was accompanied by a demonstration of fewer heart cells that died from a heart attack. Another study, also done in rats, showed that urolithin A protected rats from atherosclerosis. Lastly, urolithin A from consumption of red raspberries was shown to be correlated with improved endothelial function, or function of our vascular system, in humans. Third, the brain. Urolithin A is one of those few compounds that has been shown to be able to cross the blood-brain barrier, meaning it can enter the brain space. This makes it a very valuable chemical, as many other antioxidant chemicals cannot cross the blood-brain barrier and are therefore useless inside the brain. Trivia time. What other molecule can traverse the blood-brain barrier? Any guesses? Curcumin from turmeric, which has been shown to cross the blood-brain barrier and diminish neuroinflammation. There are many studies that show that urolithin A is neuroprotective and could potentially show benefit in neurodegenerative diseases like Alzheimer's disease. One of the early features of Alzheimer's disease is mitochondrial dysfunction within the brain, and it is increasingly being recognized as a key contributor to the disease process. Because urolithin A has been shown to improve mitophagy and overall mitochondrial health, and because it can cross the blood-brain barrier, it's nicely positioned to be a beneficial compound in the prevention of Alzheimer's disease and dementia. Urolithin A also has been shown to decrease neuroinflammation. Animal studies demonstrate the ability of urolithin A to increase learning, improve memory and neuronal survival, and increase neurogenesis, or generation of new neurons in the hippocampus. This is quite promising research. Another study found urolithin A to be protective in a model of ischemic stroke. There was less volume of the brain area damaged from the stroke and less consequent neurological deficits. Recently, urolithin A was shown to have a neuroprotective effect in a mouse model of multiple sclerosis. The compound seemed to reduce MS incidence and severity, and it also reduced inflammation and white matter demyelination, which is one of the hallmarks of MS. Fourth, the bones and joints. Supplementing with urolithin A appears to improve the damage caused by osteoarthritis. The cartilage in between the joints appeared to degenerate slower with urolithin A intake. Fifth, the GI tract. Urolithin A is created in the gut, so you would be correct to think it has strong effects here. There are some studies that demonstrate the ability of urolithin A to improve the gut epithelial lining, thereby limiting a condition known as leaky gut. Urolithin A appears to have a protective effect against inflammatory bowel diseases like Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis. Newer studies have shown lower levels of colon inflammation with intake of urolithin A. Lastly, multiple studies have demonstrated that urolithin A appears to have a chemopreventative effect when it comes to colon cancer, meaning in vitro, it's been shown to suppress the growth of colon cancer cells with long-term use. Six, the kidney. Urolithin A appears to increase tubular cell survival and protect against acute kidney injury. Some chemotherapy agents have been shown to cause kidney injury or nephrotoxicity. Several animal studies have shown that administering urolithin A can decrease the amount of damage to the kidneys that these drugs cause. Researchers think this is due to the strong antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties of urolithin A. Seventh, metabolic diseases like type 2 diabetes, obesity, and high cholesterol. Urolithin A has been shown to decrease abdominal waist circumference in humans, and it's been shown to protect against obesity and insulin resistance caused by a high-fat diet. There are a multitude of urolithin A benefits that seem to have action against diabetes, and they're mainly anti-inflammatory, anti-obesity, and cytoprotective, or protective towards our cells. So all in all, lots of very interesting data on many different fronts. We must remember, though, the majority of the data is done on animal studies. There's very few studies that examine the benefit of urolithin A in human beings. There are two notable human studies to discuss. First, a randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled clinical trial showed that supplementing with up to 2,000 milligrams of urolithin A daily for 4 weeks was safe. The study also demonstrated that the compound was bioavailable and positively impacts mitochondria with minimal to no adverse effects seen. Another study published in the Journal of the American Medical Association earlier this year looked at supplementation of urolithin A in older adults. They looked at muscle endurance and mitochondrial health. This also was a randomized clinical trial. They concluded from that trial that, quote, the long-term supplementation was beneficial for muscle endurance and plasma biomarkers, suggesting that urolithin A may counteract age-associated muscle decline. However, future work is needed to confirm this finding, they said. I couldn't agree more. We definitely need more randomized controlled trials and stronger data in human beings. That being said, all of this preliminary data is very exciting, and there's a definite strong signal that this compound is beneficial for overall human health. We also need to learn much more about the human and microbiome-assisted metabolism and creation of urolithin A. Why are some people better metabolizers than others? Why does the creation of urolithin A in our GI tract decrease the older we get? Is there any way that we can manipulate our microbiome so we can create more of this useful compound? All these questions need to be answered, and I'm sure they will be in the near future. All right, it's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed this video on urolithin A. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to show us some real support, subscribe. We love hearing from you, so leave a comment down below just for us. Let us know if you're planning to incorporate more pomegranates, walnuts, and berries into your diet to increase your urolithin A levels. Or are you going to look for a supplement? Let us know. Until next time, stay safe, stay healthy, and aloha.